Welcome to this training module for version 5 of Xorcom CompletePBX. My name is Keith Bookman, and today I want to talk about the basic steps for setting up an IVR, also known as an interactive voice response system or a digital receptionist. The IVR dialog is part of the incoming calls menu group. IVR allows you to configure the system to answer a call and redirect the call in response to input from the caller. The IVR plays a pre-recorded message to the caller that asks them to press various buttons on their telephone depending on which department or person they would like to speak with. The IVR system will then route the call in accordance with their input. There are many optional parameters in the dialog which allow you detailed control of the IVR. These options are fully documented in the Complete PBX reference guide, which you can download from the Xorcom website. It is important that you carefully plan the call flow and branching options while considering the user experience. IVRs use customized announcements, so you will need to make sure that they are clear and meaningful and easy for the user to understand. Factors that you should consider include: what to do when there is no input from the caller, what action to take if the caller provides invalid input, do you want to allow the caller to backtrack if they make a mistake or get lost? Do you want to allow the caller to return to the IVR if voicemail is encountered? You can take advantage of time-based branching by defining time groups for normal office hours. You can define a time condition and set one destination if the time matches and a different destination if the time does not match. The description should be meaningful so that the purpose of the IVR is clear to other Complete PBX administrators. Let's call this IVR Customer Support. The welcome message is not mandatory, but if you don't have one, the callers will not know what to do. To create a welcome message or any other message to be used in the IVR, you will need to make a custom recording using feature code *92. For full instructions, view the training module for announcements. Invalid destination determines how to handle the call if the caller provides invalid input. You may want to direct him back to the beginning of the IVR to give him the opportunity to hear all the dial options again, or you could send the call to an operator. Timeout destination determines how to handle the call if the user does not provide valid input within a predefined period of time. As with invalid input, you may want to direct him back to the beginning of the IVR to give him the opportunity to hear all the dial options again, or you could send the call to an operator. So we're going to send all these calls to Susan, and she will help the people out in the case that they don't manage with the system. Now we need to go to the Entries tab and define the IVR options. There are three parameters for each option. The first is the digit to press to activate the option, for example, 1. The second is the module to be activated. So I could send this call, if they press 1, to the extension of Iran. To add more options, I just click the Add button. I can do 2. I want to send this now to another IVR. There it is. And we can add a third one. 3. Select the module. We'll go to a ring group. The engineers. Now we're done. Once you have finished defining all the options, click on the Save button to save the new IVR in the database. Note the red reload icon that appears at the top of the screen. If you have finished making all your configuration changes, you will need to click on this icon to cause the running system to be updated with any changes that you have made. So now, anyone calling the customer support IVR will be able to choose how to navigate the system. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions or comments, please contact us at info@xorcom.com.